like you ever felt.
Are you listening? Damn.
Hi guys, welcome to the video number 6 for the Canon EOS 5D Mark II. And we're going to have a look at the playback menu number 1 in this video. So first one we'll look at is Protect Images. Now, I don't know if anyone watching has ever gone through deleting images from a card, trying to pick images at random, deleting them, and accidentally deleted the wrong image and thought, crap, I wanted that one. You can actually go into here and choose Set to lock the image. As you can see, there's a key icon there, so it will prevent you from accidentally deleting it. However, I don't recommend deleting images from the camera. Wait until you've offloaded the card at home, then delete the files. That way you have everything still on the memory card, on the camera, of course, as well as an extra redundant backup, if you will. So we'll come off that. Rotate. We can rotate an image. This will be useful if you're going to print directly from the camera. Not that anybody does. Well, there you go. You can rotate the image before printing, or just rotate the image before copying it over to a computer or showing it somebody on the back of the camera or showing it somebody on a TV if you connect the camera to a TV or a monitor, and so on and so on. It's not something that I generally use myself. Now, one other thing to note regarding the rotate, auto rotate, which is in the menu along here. We'll just quickly look at this. I've got mine set to computer only. That way, when I take a portrait orientation shot, it displays on the full size of the screen rather than the middle of the screen. That way, so I get a larger preview. I don't know why, by default, it's set to do camera and monitor or computer. So I always turn that stupid thing off. So I get a full preview when I'm shooting portrait orientation shots. So we'll go back to that menu. Erase images. We can go into this and select individual images to erase and highlight them or mark them to be erased in a batch, if you will, delete of images. Again, not something I would recommend doing. Wait until you've got your cards offloaded, images backed up, then you can do the deleting from your main drive that you work from, unless you've got a backup, plus you've still got the redundancy on the card as well. You can also delete all images in a folder. The camera will create multiple folders once you've gone through the image file numbers. Remember, the image file number counter goes up to 9999 and then it resets. So to prevent overwriting of files, it goes into another folder and restarts that counter and then carries on. So you can delete a whole folder if you wish, or you can delete all images on the card, except, notice there, the protected images if you have any on there. Not something, again, I would recommend doing. Wait until you've got your files off. Delete them before you go into Lightroom or from Lightroom using Delete from Disk. That way you know you've got things backed up. And the way to really delete everything off your memory card is come next use, format it, done. Fresh format, off you go. One other tip as well regarding memory cards, if you've got multiple cards, I keep the memory cards loaded with the shoot for a week or two, depending. Now, the amount of time varies because if I'm busy, I'm cycling through cards a bit faster, but at least I'll put a used card face down in the memory card pack, bring a new one out, and then I'll format that last face down card when I come to run out of cards, if you will, and I need to start going through them. That way it gives me an extra couple of weeks redundancy keeping work and images on the memory card. So worst case scenario, I can come back to the card and grab the images off there, hopefully. You know, if a major hard drive failures, servers fail, backups disappear, whatever, I've got an extra backup, if you will, whilst it's not off-site, but it's on the card still. Okay, print order. You can tell the camera to print images based on date, file number, in a particular order, so you've got the prints piled up there on your printer, ready to pick up, and they're in the right order for you. I don't really print from the camera, don't really print anything at home, to be honest with you. And it won't let me actually do this from here because it can't print RAW files. I'd have to have JPEGs on the card for that to work. There we go. So we'll go back to the menu, and you have transfer order in terms of quantity of images, transferring images over for prints, copying them from the camera to the computer. Most of the time you're going to open the door for the memory card, take the memory card out, plug them into the printer, plug it into your computer, print from that, offload the cards from that, rather than having to route around for the USB cables that always break, that always seem to go missing. It's like they go on holiday and never come back, the strange things. I mean, we buy loads of these during our life and they all disappear, strangely. So that's there should you need to connect the camera and transfer files. It can also be done via the Canon EOS utility software as well, and also via Windows and basic computer operating system options, file transfers, dialog windows that come up as well. So that's the playback menu number one, and what we'll do, we'll have a quick look at playback menu number two in the next video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. You can post these in groups, link to the playlist on your own sites, do whatever you wish, embed them, I don't mind. Just let people know that they're out there, and if you know someone that these tutorials will help, drop them an email, send them a Facebook message, whatever, and then just share this stuff, because it's been done really to help people. So thank you very much, and we will see you in the next video.